This is Jinu Joseph, Editor-in-Chief of Modern Plastics India and Modern Plastics TV. Mr. Prashant, welcome to Modern Plastics TV. Could you please tell us something about your company, Deepak Fertilizers, and its products range and operations?
Deepak Fertilizer is one of the largest producers of petrochemicals and fertilizers in the country. Apart from the manufacturing of petrochemicals, we are also the largest importers of various solvents in Indian market. If you talk about Deepak Fertilizer, we have four verticals. First vertical, industrial chemicals, where we produce methanol, isopropyl alcohol, nitric acid, CO2, and propane. Another vertical is technical ammonium nitrate, which is called as explosive chemicals or mining chemicals, where we have different grades of ammonium nitrate, solid, coated, uncoated, and we are the largest producer of ammonium nitrate in Southeast Asia region. Third vertical is fertilizer, where we are the only producer of nitrophosphate fertilizer in India. Recently, we have expanded our capacity of NPK fertilizers. This is a 600 KT plant, which we have commissioned last year. And apart from that, we do a lot of trading of soluble, water-soluble fertilizers and bulk fertilizers. And total company is growing at CAGR of 12% for the last 5 years. And this year, we are expecting growth of around 70%. That's all about Deepak Fertilizer.
What are the challenges you face during importing and trading?
See, we have started this trading business 5 years back, and it was started from the scrap. So it was zero business. And in the last 5 years, we have moved from zero turnover to current turnover of almost 2,500 crore in trading business. And we found most of the petrochemicals, especially downstream petrochemicals, are short in India, where Indian refining industry, they are focusing on basically polyethylene, polypropylene, and basic downstream, but they are not going beyond that. So all those solvents basically going to pharma industry, agro industry, inks and coating industries, they are coming from imports from China, Korea, at times it's coming from Europe, US. So this solvents industry is at present dominated by imports. So when you look at the imports, a basic infrastructure which India needs is the adequate port and adequate berth available at the ports. At present, berthing of vessel is a big challenge. Almost every vessel is going into detention, and this is net loss to the country. One day vessel demurrage translates to almost $20,000. So if vessel waits for 5 days, $1 lakh gone. This is a national loss to the country. So that's the biggest challenge. Apart from that, adequate infrastructure is not there at various ports to handle some petroleum commodities like LPG, propylene, butylene, or cumin. So those kind of tanks are also not available at various ports, so which is creating problem. And apart from that, if you see India, interest cost is almost 6 to 8%, whereas globally funds are available at 1 to 2%. So these are the challenges, but in spite of those challenges, India is doing well on import industry because there is net deficit of most of the solvents.
What is the message you want to give to the Indian plastic industry or Indian petrochemical industry?
See, if you look at the current country's vision, so India is growing very fast. If you see the consumption of various plastic and PVC compound in India market as a developing country is almost 1/3 or 1/4 of the global consumption norms. So what I understand, global consumption, say like for example, per capita plastic consumption in India is around 10 kg, whereas average global consumption is 30 kg per capita. Developed countries like US, Europe, their average per capita consumption is 40, 60, that kind of level. So I see there is a potential to grow at 3 to 4 times in next 5 years' time. Apart from that, Indian government is promoting various schemes like Make in India, Shining India, then housing for all the people by 2020. So all these growth plans are going to create big infrastructure developments in the country. And as infra industry is growing, definitely it is going to help plastic and polymer industry because they are the backbone of the infra industry.
How do you feel coming to AICON Petrochemical Conference?
See, AICON Conference, first time I'm attending, and I found it fantastic platform to get connected with various refinery, oil companies, people. So since today morning, I'm attending all the speakers. And the kind of inputs and the kind of plans Indian refineries, Indian oil companies, the kind of investment they are planning, I'm sure we're going to see a different kind of level, you know, where Indian petrochemical industry can grow. And through ICON now, we are getting ideas ki which are the downstream industries where we as a processing industry can focus. Like polyethylene is going to be surplus, ethylene is going to be surplus, propylene is going to be surplus. There are some other commodities which will be getting produced by 2030 or 2020 in phase manner. So based on those downstream petroleum and petrochemical product, companies like Deepak, we can think of our future investment plan. So it's a good platform to get connected with people. And further, it all depends upon us ki how we leverage those strengths. So it's a good conference. I'm very happy and proud to be here.
Thank you so much, Mr. Prashant. Thank you so much for being with Modern Plastics TV. Have a nice time at AICON conference.